Penguin Random House Audio presents The Lyme Solution, a five-part plan to fight the inflammatory autoimmune response and beat Lyme disease, by Darin Ingels, ND. Read for you by Rob Shapiro. For all of my fellow Lymies, may this book inspire you and help you to find solutions to better health. Foreword. It's likely that most people reading this book either know someone suffering from Lyme disease or have experienced this disease personally. For those who haven't, unfortunately, the odds are increasing that you will. According to the Centers for Disease Control, CDC, Lyme disease is the fastest-growing vector-borne infectious disease in the United States, with more than 300,000 people per year infected annually. That is 10 times more Americans than previously reported, according to the International Lyme and Associated Diseases Society, ILADS, an organization that promotes education on Lyme disease. It may surprise you to learn that no study in existence demonstrates that the standard treatment of 30 days of antibiotic therapy cures chronic Lyme disease. In other words, a rising vector-borne illness is now being treated with an unproven approach. It may work for some people, but many more fail to recover. And the disease persists. The end result is that millions of people are left struggling with a debilitating and chronic ailment on their own. And what makes it worse is the persistent autoimmune problems that Lyme disease creates. In my New York Times best-selling books, The Autoimmune Solution and The Thyroid Connection, I talk about how microbes can trigger autoimmune disease, including Hashimoto's disease, rheumatoid arthritis, lupus, and multiple sclerosis. I have seen more and more people in my own practice whose autoimmune disease and chronic health problems are directly the result of Lyme disease. It is becoming increasingly clear that Lyme disease is more than just an infection that needs to be killed. Enter The Lyme Solution. In this book, Dr. Ingels has recalibrated the lens through which we see and understand Lyme disease, using the best 21st century science and know-how. Currently, the healthcare system is making the poor trade-off in which ineffective attempts to kill off a complex bug, or in reality multiple bugs, wind up undermining the immune system while rendering the bugs stronger. In contrast, the Lyme Solution plan strengthens and supports the immune system and thereby reduces symptoms, lessens infection, and ultimately defeats the invader. To any long-term Lyme sufferer I know, that will sound almost too good to be true. But it is true. Dr. Ingels provides a true functional medicine approach to Lyme disease, not only looking at the infection itself, but also the myriad of other underlying problems that can weaken your immune system and makes Lyme disease worse. He clearly lays out a diet plan that can help improve your gut health and make your immune system stronger. Dr. Ingels shows you the importance of controlling your environment, avoiding toxic chemicals and mold, and living a healthier lifestyle, which can bring about positive changes in your overall health. Lyme disease is complicated and affects sufferers differently, but the Lyme Solution can help you start to heal and reclaim your health. I've known Darin Ingels for several years and referred many of my own patients and friends. I myself have even sought out his advice, always with excellent results. To anyone who has followed the extraordinary health breakthroughs proffered by functional medicine, his approach makes total sense scientifically, and it also delivers practically. I know that from following the clinical results. Make no mistake about it, the Lyme Solution is not a quick fix or a silver bullet. It is not as simple as swallowing a pill. It requires a commitment to your health. But most often, adjusting your diet and lifestyle and following the clinically proven protocols to boost the immune system will deliver what other approaches fail to: real results in managing your symptoms, restoring your health, and giving you back your life. And that is truly priceless. Wishing you great health, Amy Myers, MD. Part 1. Introduction to the Lyme Solution. Chapter 1. Why Antibiotics Aren't Enough. Lyme disease can strike anyone, anywhere. You don't need to live in a deer-ridden area of the East Coast of the United States. People from urban areas like New York City, Los Angeles, and Sydney, Australia, as well as arid places like Phoenix and Saudi Arabia, contract Lyme disease. It has been identified in more than 80 countries around the world. Lyme has afflicted countless people in the public eye, including Avril Lavigne, Richard Gere, and George W. Bush. It's even gotten to the point that scientists have now identified the factors that determine a higher prevalence of ticks. Warmer weather increases the mice population, which transmits Lyme disease to deer. In addition to the growing number of Lyme cases, other insect-borne illnesses, such as Rocky Mountain spotted fever, dengue virus, malaria, and Zika virus, are also on the rise. Some of these diseases are transmitted through a tick bite, like Lyme, but others are spread through the bites of mosquitoes, fleas, or flies. As I mentioned earlier, deer are not the only Lyme disease carriers. Other small animals, including mice, rats, rabbits, and squirrels, contribute to the spread of Lyme disease. Rising global temperatures will trend toward more insect-borne diseases in the coming years. The discovery of Lyme disease. No one knows exactly when Lyme disease started to emerge, but evidence suggests it has been around for thousands of years. The oldest known person to have been exposed to Borrelia is Ötzi the Iceman, a 5,300-year-old mummy found in the Austrian Alps. Modern Lyme disease was rediscovered in 1975 when some children living near Lyme, Connecticut, started to experience symptoms that looked like juvenile rheumatoid arthritis, a rare condition. Because far more children were affected than the national average, their illness began to be referred to as Lyme arthritis. Several adults in the area had similar symptoms. When a rheumatologist at Yale University began to treat some of them with antibiotics, many improved, suggesting some type of bacteria had caused the arthritis. But the true culprit of Lyme disease had yet to be identified. In the early 1980s, tick samples were sent to Dr. Willy Bergdorfer, a microbiologist and expert in Rocky Mountain spotted fever, to figure out what was causing this mysterious inflammatory infection. Although he was looking for a different infection, he noticed spirochetes, flexible, spiral-shaped bacteria, in many of the ticks he had tested. When he tested people with Lyme disease, he found they had the identical bacteria. Bergdorfer published his research in 1984, making the link between this newly discovered spirochete and Lyme disease. The organism was aptly named Borrelia bergdorferi in honor of his finding. Once scientists started to realize that Borrelia caused more than just arthritis, it was renamed Lyme disease. Lyme disease is complicated for many reasons that this book will reveal. For one thing, current testing is woefully inadequate. The Lyme organism itself morphs to hide from the immune system. Nor is there any one treatment for everyone with Lyme disease. Doctors and other healthcare providers lack Lyme awareness, especially in areas of the world where it is not considered common. All of these factors make it difficult to get an accurate diagnosis and early and proper treatment. Many lives and careers have been ruined by Lyme disease. Suicide rates are higher among people with chronic Lyme. Some people are wiped out financially. And most health insurance companies will cover only 28 days or so of antibiotic treatment. As a physician friend of mine remarked, That may be enough to get rid of your bullseye rash, but it's often not enough to get rid of the Lyme. With Lyme now epidemic, the healthcare system has a long way to go. Long-range approaches to a complex and volatile ailment like Lyme are not its strong suit. I wrote the Lyme Solution to be a straightforward, easy-to-read guide on how people with Lyme disease can take control of their own health and make use of new, innovative treatments that have not.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.